What about then the integral of sine of x by e to the cos of x dx? In this case, we have an exponential that is e to the cos of x. So this looks similar to the integral of e to the x, which is e to the x. In this case, we could think about cos of x to be g of x, since the difference between e to the cos of x and e to the x is only that x has been replaced by cos of x. But now we need to check if substitution is the right technique to apply. And for that, we need to ask ourselves, do we have the derivative of g multiplying or almost? The derivative of g in this case is minus sine of x. And we do have sine of x multiplying inside the integral. Therefore, minus sine of x is simply a multiple of sine of x, which means substitution is the right technique to apply. In this case, we will call u to cos of x. Therefore, du dx is minus sine of x. In order to leave dx by itself, we'll cross multiply, so du is equal minus sine of x dx. And then if we divide across by minus sine of x, we get dx is equal du over minus sine of x. With this, we can rewrite the integral of sine of x by e to the cos of x dx as the integral of sine of x by e to the u by du over minus sine of x. If you realize, sine of x cancels with sine of x, and we are left with the integral of e to the u by du over minus 1. If we take that minus 1 outside as a minus, we have minus the integral of e to the u du. And the integral of e to the u is simply e to the u. Therefore, the answer is minus e to the u plus c. As we are doing substitution, we need to bring x back. So the answer is minus e to the cos of x plus c.